I can't even. Okay, well, the voice acting budget ran out. Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Nicktoons Unite. Last episode, we entered Bikini Bottom. Did we enter Bikini Bottom? I think we did. Or maybe we were doing more things in Bikini Bottom. In fact, we were doing more things in Bikini Bottom. We entered Bikini Bottom 2 episodes ago. And we're fighting a secret agent. I don't know if we're given a name. Secret Agent Star, I think they were called. Well, of course. We're kind of used to opposition. So you might notice I switched the costumes back to defaults. I didn't really see a reason to... reason for or against that, so I just kind of stuck with this. I also... set the music. The music by default is on 50%. Set to 100, because it's really freaking quiet. It kind of gives the impression of this game being really quiet in general, which it is, but even more so. Which I don't like, so... if for some reason or another that bothers you guys, go for ahead and say so, but otherwise I'll just like to... read the thing. Oh! I hate when items spawn so quickly. Or enemy drops. But anyways, I'll just keep using default costumes unless somebody... really does want to use it for the rest of the series. Not really see much reason for or against, so I'm just gonna stick with this for now. You know, it would be kind of nice if instead of these weird mooks, you smart guy, Jimmy, using your shield. I forgot I had that. Snowdrop, get over here. It would be kind of nice if they had, like, generic mooks that were specific to each world you were in. Instead of always having these green guys absolutely everywhere that have the same attacks. Having more variety in the enemies in general would be nice. And I think they have the robots on a little things instead of wheels in this world, but even then, it's not much. And more than anything, I'm just confused as to why there are these green guys everywhere anyways. It's never explained why you have these green guys everywhere. They don't belong to any one universe or anything like that. And we're never told that the Syndicate has, like, other people working with them, from what I remember. Just that it's the four different members of the Syndicate working together. In fact, none of the members of the Syndicate would normally have people working for them either, so it's kind of odd. It's a minor detail, but it sticks out to me for some reason. And usually there's more of an explanation for these sorts of things in the other Nicktoons Unite games. And the robots that you fight make sense, as well as the different robots you would fight, whoops, in Amity Park. But here, well, in any place that these green things appear all over in, I don't really get why they're here. Oh, well, the music just got interesting right when it stopped. Never mind, it's normal again.
Quietly. No one must know we are here until we find Agent Star.
Hey, SpongeBob! Don't tell anyone, but Sandy made me a secret agent!
Top-notch animation.
Patrick! Watch out for that jellyfish harvester!
Okay.
Patrick, no!
Delayed reaction.
Kind of.
What can we see? He's inside the machine.
Sponge, help! SpongeBob, help! Help! Sponge!
Oh, never mind.
Sponge!
What's hurting him? He's just sitting in the net.
Don't worry, SpongeBob. We'll get him back. Let's stick to Sandy's plan. We'll take out these jellyfish harvesters and then enter Plankton's fortress. We'll find Patrick there.
Probably. I guess. Although now they probably know that Patrick was an agent, so... oh, well, that's not a very blatant hint at all. Alright, fine. If that's how you want to do it. Oh, I don't need to stun or anything. Ow. At least you just make it small. Which is what it's... Oh no! Don't leave me be. Basically, just make it small. And then... Okay, the charge attack isn't really useful in this game. Oh, whoa. Why can't I shrink this thing from the inside? I don't really need that for anything. I don't know why it has, like, a smallness gauge. Or a gauge gets depleted when you make it small. That's the gauge it's usually used for, like, whoops. Whoa! It'd be nice if these guys could dodge, at least, even though I can't. But still, it kind of weirds me out that they have that. I don't know why they wouldn't just omate the triple gauge entirely. God, guys. Literally every time, they all get picked up. Oh, and then Jane just kind of decides to appear. Thank you. Did that health respawn? No, I don't know if the big health... I don't think the big health pickups normally respawn. I recall if they do or not. New thing. Anyways, there's some more to be explored over here anyways. So let us do that. You might think that you ought to go through those big doors over there, but... What's this thing? What? Okay, now I'm kind of confused. Yes, there's water here. What's that thing we pick up for, though? In fact... I don't believe you go through these doors yet, though. No. So these we need to open from somewhere else. However, of course, you do actually go through those doors, because otherwise it would be kind of dumb for them to have... the arrows, not arrows, but the coins leading up to it. Yay, I picked a couple things. Why is there an invisible wall here? Why are there invisible walls that are preventing me from... I never understood the point of invisible walls between two areas that are mutually accessible in a game. Oh, wait, I can actually... It's not mutually accessible in this case, never mind. I've seen multiple instances of that in games, and it's kind of... It always bugs me. Just because it's restricting freedom in a completely unnecessary manner. In fact, the main example that comes to mind is in a game where... there's a ramp, followed by a gap immediately after that, but if you hit that ramp, you just hit an... Well, not a gap, but a fence immediately after that ramp. And if you... hit that ramp, you'll just smash into an invisible wall above the fence. It's kind of weird that they would do that, but... Said game is Wii Sport, not Wii Sports, Wii Ski. But anyways, I'm not going to get into the specifics of Wii Ski while playing Nicktoons Unite. That all sounds like a fun game to do a Let's Play of, except it'd be kind of dumb. That, and it's not really a Let's Playable game. And I guess if I was playing with somebody else, it could be mildly entertaining while I... just do it with other people, because there are different things to complete in the game, but I don't think it'd be very fun to do it on your own. I don't know. If I get more Wii games working on my Wii again, since I have to boot stuff off of a flash drive, who knows. But anyways. You know, something I forgot about. I know there was a jellyfish earlier, some job, that I could have shot water at. I'm not sure if it would have done anything for me or not, though. How do I shoot this guy? Just lets you go up here and get more water. Yes! This is exactly what I wanted. So drop. Oh! Oh! Whoops. Okay, so I see what the issue is. So as you saw there, if we fall while full of water, we'll lose all of our water once we hit the ground. So in this case... come on, I didn't hit the jellyfish. So in this case, what we want to have happen... I can barely make that jump. But what I want to have happen in this case is I need... And I do indeed need to make use of this jellyfish. What I do is I jump on the jellyfish, I pick up the water. Instead of just dropping down, I fall on the jellyfish. Yeah, except I didn't. Oh, Danny! This Goomba stomped me! Jerk. And then Danny fell. But if I could actually land on the jellyfish, seems a little bit more difficult than it ought to be. What the? Ow! Oh well, that worked. It got me where I needed to be. The edge boosting is a wonderful thing in video games. But seriously, I can't actually jump when I'm full of water. I can kind of do some sort of meager attempt at it, but it doesn't act. It's just an animation. And then I just lost all my water immediately. Ow. Okay, seriously, game, what are you doing? Like I said before, this game isn't the best. I really only appreciate it, and it's fun, but I mostly only appreciate it for what it made happen later on in the series, because it made the rest of the series happen. What's over here? Wait, that's just backtracking. I can't switch characters while I'm using this. Okay. Take 6. So it's again. Can I not just shoot it from here?
What did you do?
Oh, it lets you bounce on them. For some reason, I took that to say that you could fall onto a jellyfish. Well, okay, that was just entirely my fault. Alright. I don't get to criticize the game this time. Danny, get over here. Danny. Well, Danny too, I guess, but Jimmy. Primarily. What? Well, I guess it's fine if it still attacks me. Why can't I shrink it again before it sweeps us all up? And thank you for conveniently throwing us at the health. I still think Jimmy's attack is kind of weird in this game. It's like it's trying to be ranged, but it's not. It's a weird mock-up of a ranged attack that doesn't really have much range at all. But also isn't incredibly easy to actually aim. And one more go. Go away! And we're good. For some reason it turns to water. I guess it runs on steam or something. Oh hey, it's that thing. Not. What? Whoa! Explosion. Oh, SpongeBob. 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 Thank you, I guess. Oh, SpongeBob. I keep getting stuck. Thank you. Okay, now that is a case in which I can't criticize this game. I've gotten into my fair share of dumb things in this game already, haven't I? Primarily that one crash, but... I should get hurt any as I spin on them. Be dumb, kind of funny. Pretty sure you can't, though. Oh, well, in case you're wondering, stomping does indeed inflict damage on enemies, even though it's, usually used for stunning, it just does very little damage. Hey, a thing. Not sure why it is, I could punch through solid rock, but whatever.
Boom.
Go away. I guess I'm not gonna get your collectibles now. But oh well. Me too. I guess I can appreciate this place having lots of stuff for SpongeBob. Okay, how about this? Precisely. It's kind of an interesting tactic, I guess. I'm assuming that I can recover safely. Just forcing the suicide of my enemies. A cruel yet effective tactic. Come on, guys. The AI in this game isn't the best either. That being your friendly AI. Not that the enemy AI is exactly genius in comparison either, though. But it's kind of annoying having to babysit your other teammates whenever you're not controlling them. At the same time, though, I had to be able to hit destroy that barrel. At the same time, though, the game still manages to be really easy just because of all the pickups it gives you everywhere. And the overwhelmingly simple gameplay, but that's another matter. All the other games in the Nicktoons Unite series seem to really acknowledge that whole difficulty thing, and they really up the difficulty of the later games. And in Battle for Volcano Island, they actually did reward you, or at least acknowledged you, like, not doing a bad job, but came to dying all the time, and falling off cliffs and whatnot. I got her. As well as offering, like, challenges and things like that. What was it? I don't think I wanted the other thing from this. Versus the cost of the power. Meh. Versus cost. Seems too situational to be useful. Be charged. I'm guessing the second one is just makes it cost less. Shrink Ray. Oh, I guess I should just upgrade everybody's damage. Darn it. No, don't go away. Start button, because I'm ready. Alright. This isn't very SpongeBob-like music, you know? What? It's the cucumber. Why would I ever want to possess one of the normal moves? Wait, it's this thing again. What is the point of these? It's just like a shell of its former self. Oh, I lost the shell, didn't I? No? Yes! Oh, you! I hate you. Let me change to Jimmy so I can shrink the darn thing. Well, I guess shrinking it was if somebody else didn't want to be the best idea. Nope. I was trying to run. I don't quite recall, actually. I'm not sure if the second upgrade to your attacks, to your basic attack, actually increases your attack damage or not. I'm tempted to say it does. I heard it saying something really generic, like it just makes your attack more powerful or something, which I guess would be taken to mean that. I'm gonna abandon all of you guys, because you guys are just kind of dumb and get sucked up all the time. I kind of just teleport it when I shrink him sometimes. Oh, wait. Oh, whoops. Hit me to accidentally charge that attack. I'm sure I could do that. I think we could all use some health. Whoa, Danny? Timmy? Did I shrink them somehow? Oh god! Oh no! Oh no! I don't think that's supposed to happen. Oh, now I'm bigger. So I think that's what happens if you accidentally overcharge your shrink ray attack or something like that. It ends up shrinking you too. Which admittedly is kind of funny. Stop. illusions. What's up here? Oh, that's actually some really good stuff. Having multiple tasks that somebody can take in these kinds of levels in a game. So that's kind of a good and a bad thing, because that's some exploring and whatnot, but at the same time, if they want to see all the things that there are to be found, they're not really sure which way to go, when it's not obvious which way progresses and which way just gives you some more things. Man, that attack, that charge attack uses a lot of energy. Well, I guess it's something to use my energy for, because I'm not really using it much of anything otherwise. Timmy, don't you dare touch a jellyfish. Okay, good. Why don't I just shrink, like, everything in my way, instead of just deciding that I should shrink specific rocks? Oh, that's a thing to my left. What? Darn it. Stop. How did I punch you? Ow. Go away. That's not, this isn't what I want. Go away. I'm not trying to charge attacks, I'm trying to make my attacks work. Thank you. Alright, Jimmy, what do you have now? You get a thing. You'll see what that thing is next time, the next episode of Let's Play Nicktoons. Okay, never mind. Sure, I guess. I have a flare. And I have goggles. I forgot I did this. It's actually kind of useful.
Let's get tight.
No. There we go. Oh, that hit my head. Alright, so I guess I'll see you guys in the next episode of Let's Play Danny Unit Health. Danny, get over here! See you guys in the next episode of okay. Let's Play Nicktoons Unite. Since I'm just about out of time. And I'm probably not going to run into any decent stopping points anytime soon. So see you guys then when we do more stuff. Hopefully when we find Patrick. Actually, I'm pretty sure we will. And if not, we did find a rather mysterious glowing green object. The hound's in front of us right now, actually. We can investigate what that is next time. Because there's a lot more to be seen near Bikini Bottom than just plankton. See you then, guys. Bye.